Welcome to the Chortle Awards. What brings you here this evening?
I'm here because I celebrate the profession of these people who are far funnier and far more amusing in every way than myself. But to be invited is, I suppose, in some small way, a gratification for my efforts in the comedy scene.
Do you have a favourite comedian at the moment?
I've got a number of very strong influences. There's some great comedians in this country, but I think one of the most impressive and underrated comedians in the United Kingdom is Paul Foot. He is a genius. Three quarters of what he does is improvised, and even he doesn't know what he's going to say. So look out for Paul Foot. I think he's going to be big in 2011.
One of the big discussion points about comedy at the moment in the past week is the whole Top Gear Mexico thing. Where do you stand on that whole debate?
I think that people need to ease down a little bit. We are now in a world where you have to assume that everything's been recorded. And if you make a joke out of context, it just doesn't seem funny. So all I would say is, come on people, what kind of world do we want to live in? Let's lighten up. Let's recognize that there aren't many racists and there aren't many sexists in this country. But if we carry on like this, then we won't have many comedians either.
Do you think there is a line, though, that can be crossed?
People do sometimes cross a line, and oftentimes they have to apologize for it. But with great comedy, sometimes there comes some risk. If you take away the risk, then you take away the humor, and you take away the unpredictability. So I would simply say, let's celebrate the diversity of the human race, recognize that sometimes you can say some pretty irreverent things, but not be a prejudicial person.
Have a fantastic night tonight, thank you.
I'm really looking forward to tonight, and frankly, I do feel really honored to be here. Losing has its privileges.
Brilliant, thanks very much.
My pleasure.